Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the seed. Seed, the ripened ovule is called seed. The ovules after fertilization develops into seeds. The study of seeds is called spermology. Generally, seed is made up of a seed coat and an embryo. The outermost covering of a seed is called seed coat. The seed coat composed with two layers. The outer layer is called testa and the inner layer is called tegmen. Within the seed coat, seed contains embryo. Embryo consisting of an embryonal axis and cotyledons. Cotyledons are often fleshy and full of reserve food material. One cotyledon is present in monocotyledonous plants. Examples, wheat and maize. Two cotyledons are present in dicotyledonous plants. Example, grams and pea. At the two ends of embryonal axis are present. One end is called radical and another end is called lamellum. In the germination of seed, radical forms root system and the lamellum forms shoot system. In monocotyledonous seeds, the membranous covering around the radical is called coleorhiza and around the lamellum is called coleoptile. The hilum is a scar on the seed coat through which the developing seeds were attached to the fruit. Above the hilum, a small pore is present on the seed which is called micropyle of seed. The next important thing regarding seed is endosperm. The endosperm is a tissue produced inside the seeds of most of the flowering plants by fertilization. It is triploid in most of the species. Endosperm surrounds the embryo and provides nutrition majorly in the form of starch, and sometimes it is in the form of oils and proteins. Based on the absence or presence of endosperm, seeds are broadly classified into two types. Number one, non-endospermic or exalbuminous seeds. Number two, endospermic or albuminous seeds. Number one, non-endospermic or exalbuminous seeds. Endosperm is completely consumed during development of embryo. Thus, the seeds are called non-endospermic or exalbuminous. Example, most of the dicotyledonous plants like gram, pea, groundnut. The seed coat is formed by integuments in those plants. Outer seed coat called testa and inner seed coat called tegmen. In dicotyledonous plants, mostly, they consumed endosperm. But they store food in cotyledons. The second type is endospermic or albuminous seeds, mostly in monocotyledonous and some dicotyledonous plants like castor bean. Embryo does not consume all endosperm. They consume endosperm, but not completely. So it persists in the mature seed. Such seeds are called endospermic seeds or albuminous seeds. In these seeds, food is stored in endosperm. Example, most of the monocots, some dicots like castor and datura. Let's check the diagrammatic representation of monocotyledonous seed and dicotyledonous seed. The next topic is perispermic seeds. Mostly nucellus is consumed after fertilization due to absorption of food by the endosperm and embryo. In some plants, the remains of nucellus in the seed is called perisperm, which means persistent nucellus after fertilization are present in seed is called perisperm. Perisperm is in diploid condition. Let's see examples for perispermic seeds. Piper nigrum, black pepper. Then seed germination. Seed germination is the process of seeds developing into plantlets, which means new plants. There are five important steps involved in seed germination, such as the very first is imbibition. Seeds absorbs water. Next, seeds performs respiration to get energy for germination process. Next, effect of light on seed germination. Then mobilization of reserves during seed germination and role of growth regulators, which means whatever the energy, whatever the nutrients are present in seeds, so they can mobilize. Fifth one, development of embryonal axis into seedling. We already know radical forms root system, plumule forms shoot system. These two are the parts of embryonal axis. Seed germination is of two types. Number one, epigeal germination. Number two, hypogeal germination. Number one, epigeal type of germination. In this type of germination, cotyledons are come out on soil due to elongation of hypocotyl. Example, castor and cotton. Hypogeal germination. When epicotyl elongates and cotyledons are left in the soil. Example, pea, gram, groundnut, mango. The next topic is viviparity. Sometimes seeds can germinate within the fruit while attaching to the plant. Such type of germination is called viviparity. Viviparity type of germination generally seen in mangrove plants, which means the plants which are growing in salinity area. Example, Rhizophora, Avicennia and Heritera.